time back then of 11 hours, 46 minutes, 58 seconds. That was Gordon Haller. A little picture from the race there. It's unlikely that any of those competing at that time could comprehend what they were creating with today. Over 24 sanctioned practitioner's approach. That's what I do there in New Zealand, working for the Academy of Sport. I'll start with looking at the demands of the Ironman triathlon as I see them. We'll then look at trying to prepare for those demands. And finally, we'll look at, I guess, the little 1%er things that we can do to get maybe that little advantage on the actual day and look at the performance itself. So we'll start with the demands. And we've broken the demands in part one here down into the bioenergetics of the event. We'll look at some studies into the core temperature, or how hot or how cold you get during some of these Ironman events. We'll look at body mass changes, to give us some insight into the water balance that occurs during events. And a couple of things that tend to happen quite regularly during the Ironman event, and that is the muscle cramping and the muscle damage. We'll start with the bioenergetics, and it's probably the most important aspect